I'm attorney Pat Dunn. Auto accidents are a part of life. I hope you never need an attorney, but if you do, the team at the Mack Law Firm is here to help.
We're back at the courthouse in Amy, but not on a usual day. The crew of Omega just came and left on their trek across the parish. They don't call it a trek, but they're going from one end to the other. Started in Kentwood, will wind up in Ponchatoula. Nobody knows that any better than reveler Gary Stanga, our clerk. And, well, what do you think?
Oh, man, what a group. I got to meet the king and the queen, as well as a lot of other people in the crew. Some of them, you know, I've been friends with for years. Anyway, it's a great group. I was pleased to present the king and the queen with a gift from me. And anyway, I know that they're going to have a wonderful time down the parish, as well as in the parade tonight.
You know, we can do all these celebrations, and we call them festivals, but, I mean, a chili cook-off like the one the Rotary Club has coming up, and then this event, Omega, everything turns into a party around here.
Yeah. Ham and Ponchatoula chili cook-off that they're having this weekend, I'm judging it. So I know they have a lot of stuff planned for all ages, and it should be a really good time.
Again, it just goes to show you, a chili cook-off that anywhere else would be nothing. Here, it becomes really another festival.
Oh, yeah, Ken. You know, people around here like to have a good time. And, as the French say, pass a good time. It doesn't take much of an excuse for people here to get together, have fun, fellowship together, and it's... I think it's great for the parish. A lot of people would prefer a lower scale where there's not quite as big a crowd as going to New Orleans as some of the events that they have down there, especially like Mardi Gras. And so I think it's great for the parish.
Well, in the meantime, who would have seen this coming? A new controversy. Trying to save Old Hardhide in Ponchatoula. Who would have thought?
Ken, I don't know. I don't understand the people behind that. I don't think there's a bigger animal lover than me. My passion is dogs. I have three dogs. You know, Old Hardhide's been there for years and years and years, and I really got tickled at when I saw the report on WDSU last night about the wildlife and fisheries, what they said in regards to, as basically like, well, they didn't even know it was there, and it doesn't have a right to be there. Well, where have they been? I mean, I know, I have seen people with wildlife and fisheries, and I'm not knocking them. I'm just saying, they've been in Paul's Cafe, eating breakfast or having coffee or having lunch, and the alligator cage is right there. You know, it just didn't pop up out of the ground. It's been there for years. And then at one time there was a controversy about, well, the Hardhide didn't have a den. They went in and totally redid the enclosure. Is it better for any animal in the whole wide world to be in the wild? Certainly. I don't think anybody would agree with that. But Hardhide has been there for as long as I can remember. I remember the original gator that was there, the big one. And I remember when it finally passed away after no telling how many years. And that was back when they had, Ponchatoula had a big funeral procession for it, and just like they do in New Orleans.
A jazz funeral.
A jazz funeral, yeah. And this alligator doesn't have to go look for food. It's fed on a regular basis. In fact, wildlife fishery said, maybe it was, or I'm told they said, that it was overweight. It's too fat, and it's got a hurt foot. so possibly they might have to euthanize it. Well, I'm fat, okay? I'm overweight, and my foot does hurt sometimes. Please let me live. You know, that's the most ridiculous thing in the world.
Well, it would take away a bona fide tourist attraction.
Oh, yeah, and I can't understand anybody that would be affiliated, especially with the country market. And I'm not saying there is. I'm just saying I couldn't understand anybody affiliated with the country market being opposed to that alligator being there, because I have met people. In fact, I was at Paul's this morning. I didn't meet anybody this morning because it was so early, but I've been there on many, many occasions. And you would walk out and there would be people, you know, a family, a man, wife, two or three kids, whatever, standing around the gator cage. And I'm a person who likes to make conversation, so I just ask them, where are you from? And greet them to Ponchatoula, to Tanspoho Parish. And it's, you know, those people are some of the people that eventually make their way over to go through the country market when they're open.
Well, an alligator is commonplace around here, but not so if you're from most of America. People want to be able to see them.
Yeah, I mean, that's why, you know, Clee Bears, you know, when they had to have the tours of the gator farm, that's a big attraction. I think you could talk to people with Tangi Tourism and they would tell you that people, you know, are very interested in that.
Well, you're a politician. Don't take offense at that term. Do you think that we can defeat this effort, or is it a fait accompli?
Well, all I can say is I was on the phone last night talking to different people in government that I know, and the mayor, I saw that he came out and made a statement, which I was very happy. I contacted Representative Bill Week. I saw Randy Bush on there on Facebook, who's running for Senate, and Bill's running for Senate also. But anyway, I saw where Randy was, you know, commenting on it and trying to tag people and contact people, and I think that's good. Now, you know, some people may say, well, you're overreacting because you don't know what's going to happen, what they're going to determine. Well, if you wait till the thing's dead, then it's too late to react. I mean, we have to let wildlife and fisheries know how impassioned we are about our little tourist attraction that we have, and we love that gator.
You also say that going out in the wild, which many of us do, but you do for sure, a foot problem for an alligator is not a big deal.
No. Ken, you know, I grew up out in Bedico and grew up on Bedico Creek, Tanspoho River, in the swamp. I can't tell you the number of alligators that I've seen that have one leg or part of one leg missing, or a large portion of the tail missing. You get these big bull alligators, big male alligators, and when it gets breeding season, they're really mean, and they'll tear another one up. In fact, they'll kill. I've seen, you know, 4 or 5 foot alligators, and you could tell it was where another alligator bit them. It just, chewed them up. So, that stuff happens in the wild. And I don't know. I'm all for protecting animals, but I think this has gone way overboard. And I think it's another classic case, and this is what I'm most against, no matter what it is. When you have two or three people that start complaining and cause a problem for the overwhelming majority of the people, but it seems like government bends to these two or three folks that whine instead of listening to the majority of the people.
Well, I would also say, though, if the fringe is the one who's vocal and everybody else doesn't speak up, which hopefully is not the case with Old Hardhide, but they call it now the secret majority because the majority of people, they don't want to say a word.
Well, I don't know. Last night, I finally turned everything off and went to sleep about 11, but there was a lot of activity on Facebook, and it was all pro Hardhide, and people were willing to, they wanted to know, what do we have to do? Do we need to go to Baton Rouge and picket wildlife and fisheries, or, people were just willing to join together, and, you know, a whole lot of the people that I read about on there, I don't even really personally know them, but obviously they were just as impassioned about it as I was.
It takes more than one person to assist in a personal injury claim. I am attorney Glenn Westmoreland, and we have a strong team at the Mack Law Firm. It is our goal to make sure your injury is properly attended to. Contact me at tangylawteam.com and let us get you the help you need.